Hi, this is your interest rate watch for Tuesday, September the 21st, Federal Reserve Day. A couple key points is we don't anticipate, and this is coming from the market, that the short-term interest rates are going to be adjusted by the Federal Reserve. So that's a good thing for the homeowners out there that have their home equity lines of credit that could be impacted by any sudden raises by the Federal Reserve, causing those second mortgages to have an increase in rates if you have an adjustable rate on your home equity line. The key point that we're looking for the Federal Reserve verbiage today and how that's going to impact the markets is anything that comes out of them in regards to the November 2nd and 3rd meeting next month or in the month to come. The reason for that being is right now, Goldman Sachs, as you remember last week, speculated that they're going to release another $1 trillion to stabilize the bond markets. And what that's coming, if you look at the past performance of when they started this initiative in 2009 with the mortgage buyback program or the bond investments, that actually stabilized interest rates and kept them low throughout 2009. Will that continue through 2010 and going on 2011? Well, part of that $1 trillion is, you know, speculated they're going to use this to buy, and the other side of it is, could it be used to stabilize Fannie and Freddie, which here Ben Bernanke did say they have to be released to the private markets, released off the government's leash. So it'll be interesting to see what comes from that report. So a lot of attention is faced on what the Federal Reserve is going to say today, what verbiage they're going to use, and how that's going to be translated by the markets received, and then impacting what we could see a midday price change. Could be for the best, could be for the worst, but we're still unknown to that. Second key point is, you know, good news is coming from housing starts from the building sector. The housing starts rose 10.5%. This was better than the expected reports of Wall Street, and this is the best levels that we've seen in the last 4 months. So, you know, cheers to the housing sector for trying to, you know, definitely build more homes, and hopefully the demand will be met. The unemployment report is going to be interesting to watch, because now they're definitely saying that these levels of employment may remain for the next couple of years, maybe even many years to come. And that's just because of the fact that right now corporations are basing their numbers off of the productivity of their employees. So less employees having higher productivity, well, that increased the profits. But the problem is that's not helping with the unemployment situation. So until we get this quote-unquote, a de-thawing or unfreezing of the labor markets, and these corporations begin to spend more money to hire on more individuals or spend more money with third parties that can then hire individuals, we may not see that easing that the country's looking for, that the globe's looking for in the U.S. as far as our unemployment rates. So that'll be interesting also to see. So key points we wanted to touch on, but right now, overall, hopefully today we're going to actually see interest rates improve after the Federal Reserve meeting, because more signs show positive signals that they're going to be supporting the housing market in some shape and form regarding the mortgage rates, and that's their buyback program, which will be announced in November. Big speculations, but that's what we're hearing from the Wall Street so far. So stay tuned. We'll be definitely back in touch if any breaking news happens. Otherwise, make sure to follow us on our Twitter page and also on our Facebook fan page. Talk to you tomorrow.